We sure don't have to tell you because we have all been feeling it. But today, the official numbers are out and they confirm the prices of gas, food, goods and services jumped in May, raising inflation to a new four-decade high of 8.6%. It's one of the reasons some Minnesota politicians are asking for a gas tax holiday, a temporary suspension of the state's 28-cent per gallon fuel tax. As John Croman reports, it would take action from lawmakers who may or may not be coming back to the Capitol this summer.
36 Lynn Refuel in Minneapolis always has some of the lowest prices, but at this rate, the people at the pump are feeling some real apprehension as they watch the final tally. So what's the total here?
$51.34.
Almost $60.
Part of what you pay is 28.5 cents per gallon in state fuel taxes, but with the state sitting on a record surplus, some lawmakers are pitching a temporary gas tax holiday.
And we're paying for it dollar for dollar out of the surplus. The savings is going to go directly to Minnesotans.
Representative Dan Wolgema is part of a group of DFL lawmakers who introduced the gas tax holiday bill back in February when $3.29 per gallon seemed outrageous.
We need to come back for a special session. We need to pass this gas tax holiday.
2 months earlier, on a cold December day, House Republican leader Kurt Dowd liked the idea.
Moratorium on energy taxes. Which would include a moratorium on gas taxes.
And this week, Republican Scott Jensen's GOP running mate Matt Burke tweeted in favor of it.
So what do you think about the gas tax holiday?
I think it'd be a great idea.
I like that a lot, especially as people are thinking about summer vacations and want to get out of town.
Wasn't the same reporter at the same gas station back in February asking the same questions and getting the same positive response? Well, yes, he was. It's never been a question of whether the people like the idea.
But the bill did not become a priority in the DFL-controlled House, and Senate GOP leader Jeremy Miller wrote it off as an election year gimmick.
Well, some opponents say they're worried about what will happen when the gas tax ends and the tax goes back on. They say there might be a consumer backlash that would come and bite them right in the ballot box. In St. Paul, John Croman, CARE 11 News.